We're broadcasting live from the Thunderdome in Sunniapolis, Forsk, Minnesota, home of the Purple Mutant Eaters. You can hear their anthem being played down on the field right now. Of course, written by the artist formerly known as Pimp, Purple Brain, one of the all-time classics. Now this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Grim Bay Attackers battle the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, I scared on the I am a hell of a son.
Are you ready for some MFL action?
Am I? I love MILFs. Mutants I'd like to fuck.
He said MFL, not M-I-L-F, you halfwit.
Ow! I thought you were talking about the Mayhem Bowl halftime MILF lingerie girls team. What a zombie QB with that big rack of ribs and almost no waist at all. Ho-ho! Va-va-va-voom!
And it's first and 10. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. Oh, what a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Was an all-pro MFL hit. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
The defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. That's a catch for a 1 yard gain. That's not going to do it, fellas. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And this guy is on fuego. Does he like, man, what a hit that was. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
And it's good.
You know, Grim, in this league where murder and bribery are cheered, it's good to be good, huh? I mean, can we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's 1st and 10. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1.
Trust me, he's in better shape than I am right now. Oh, geez, here it comes. Blah.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, and that one's going to hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Nice hit. Second down and 5. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. First down and 9. It's a 6-yard gain. Second and 3. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. I mean, anything really tastes good.
They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, with a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe with a headache.
Second down and 6. And he picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. That one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. Pow! With the brain scrambler. Second down and 10. Thank you. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grin?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a brawn in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Oh, I love this dirty trick. FIFO bum. Stomp him into the ground, the dirty bum. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and 3. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
Ah, pass the popcorn, Grim. Zoom in on his face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
Now, this one's going to be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him trying one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not my type, though. A little too mutilated.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Rick. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. functioning brain cells before that hit. They're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown.
What in the fuck am I watching?
And wasn't this guy in a Lost Wages all-male dance review before he signed?
Yeah, they were called Nuts and Bolts. His stage name was Vice Grip.
Okay, nice and easy like a two-foot putt.
You miss two-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
It's first and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Passes for a touchdown.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players.
You can't keep a good...
And that pass finds its target. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. And that'll be second. And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
With the brutal hit. Third down. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And that catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
And he's off to the races. defense erases the previous play by transporting the offense back in time.
I heard that Time Warp 30 trick uses advanced alien black hole technology.
And your entire life is one big black hole.
Oh, the defender just knocked the ball loose. Hell, that'll wake you up, then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
It's a touchdown.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey,
don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. Third quarter about to begin here, and these guys are locked in a nearly dead heat.
I was locked in a dead heat under the covers last night when Brick started farting like a 4th of July fireworks finale.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay.
Hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. Oh, the defender lays down a wicked hit and knocks the ball loose. The receiver just got smashed.
Not as bad as me last night. He may be dead, but trust me, he's in better shape than I am right now. Oh, geez, here it comes. Blah.
Warp speed, engage!
What are you trying to play?
And like Bricks and Files, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way!
Touchdown!
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. He's not going down. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
He picks up a 2. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's 1st and 10. Defense just called the ginormous dirty trick. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws. throws a supersonic missile to his receiver. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing.
You go toe-to-toe with me, you get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
First down and five. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. And he rumbles for 9 on that play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1.
Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's 1st and 10. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and 10. Has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. You get right range. How do you like your brain? Scramble or fry? Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back.
Apparently, the punter for the day is being played by my kid's sister.
No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's 1st and 10.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And they pick up 9 with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still nice game.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1.
Love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not your own.
And it's 1st and 10. You've got to catch that. Second down and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Third down and 9. That's the end of the third quarter. This game is going to come down to the wire.
I love that show.
And it's first and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Yeah, except the zombies. They are freaks.
Check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner. And the defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life.
Or die. He's on the pedal now. He only had...
Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. Saying, well done!
Bang, baby, bang!
They'll be washing bloody footprints off the defense's jerseys after a run like that. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you. And the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. Footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be second and 8 to go. A 6 yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Just some good old downhill running there as he picks up the first down. First and 10. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's 1st and 10. Great run for a 9 yard gain. Bring up 2nd and 1. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
And that'll bring up third and one. And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And it's first and ten. Two minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
When did they do that?
And it's first and ten. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Second down and ten. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Third down and never gonna happen. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just get the points, and let's move on.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Talk about running into a buzzsaw, Bricks.
Okay, he just ran into a buzzsaw.
And that'll bring up second and one. And that's a first down. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
Run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. He blasted and picks up 7 yards right there. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
It's good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one.
Thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today,
Today's Final Game Stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right every up.